Hello and welcome to Quentin United Church of Christ, where no matter who or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. I'm Reverend Jessica Hanley, the pastor at Quentin UCC, and we are so grateful that you are joining us for our worship service today. We come from many different places in life to this place we call church today. Some of us may be worshiping from home. Some of us are at kitchen tables and islands. Others may be in living rooms, and some may be gathered in other places that are somewhere that has yet to be named. We come to this time of worship, seeking God in our everyday lives. We come to this time of worship praising God for showing up in the days that have gone by. And we come welcoming God and one another in this space. At this time, I invite you, as our opening hymn is played, to text or call three people, sharing the peace of Christ with them. We share peace, love, hope, and joy as we journey together during this time of worship, wherever we are gathering. Let us rejoice in one another's presence here in this space with our opening hymn. It is hard to articulate what we are feeling. It is hard to speak through our masks and to be heard clearly. But we want to make certain everyone in our community knows what is going on, that everyone can hear and see what our God is doing in this world. And so at this time, we move into our time of announcements. Just a reminder that we will be worshiping in the outdoor chapel, weather permitting, for the foreseeable future. We ask that you wear your mask, practice social distancing, use hand sanitizer, And don't forget the bug spray, sunscreen, and your water bottle, as we all come together while being safe and maintaining a healthy church. In case of inclement weather, the service will be posted online and an announcement will be made on Friday via email if service will be online for that Sunday. And an important worship change to announce, starting with the worship service on September 13th, that's September 13th, the starting time of worship will change to 11 o'clock a.m. to allow for the weather to warm up a bit. We are hopeful to continue worship outdoors until mid to late October. That means it's sweater weather, so dress appropriately. Our offering for August 9th was $4,262. And another reminder just about the changes that are going on, office hours for the church are still on a very limited basis, but if you need to make contact, simply call the office at 717-273-6114 and leave a message, or email quentinucc@gmail.com. Someone will get back to you as soon as possible. If it's an emergency and you need to reach me immediately, please call me, Pastor Jess, on my cell. This number can be found in your weekly emails. The grocery cart for Joy Food donations will be placed outside the fellowship hall door for your donations as we continue to worship in the outdoor chapel. Please place these donations there as you are able. Lawnmowers for this week are the team of Bob Weiss and Chip Sadison. Thank you so much for keeping our church grounds beautiful. And a reminder from the Stewardship Committee to continue giving to our second mile efforts to meet our benevolence budget. We thank all of those who have donated so far and thank those who plan to give in the coming weeks ahead. And we give thanks for the presence of one another and for God with us where we are. Let us welcome God into this time and space with our call to worship. We hear God calling, but do we feel God in this space? We hear God calling, but do we feel it in our hearts? As we take this time to welcome God into our time of worship with our call to worship, I invite you to meditate on where God has shown up in your life this week. We breathe in God's presence in this space, feeling God in every rise and fall of our breath. We reflect on God's presence in this space. We feel God in the movement of the wind and in the stillness of the air. How good is our God? How great is our God? Our God created heaven and earth, the mountains, valleys, and seas. How great is our God? How good is our God? We breathe in the air, reminded of God in every breath that we take. How good is our God? How great is our God? We imagine the water running across our foreheads as our baptisms. We feel God's presence in our hearts. How good is our God? How great is our God? Our Creator's blessing is with us always, in all of the risings and fallings of our breath, in all of the moments we share. Thanks be to God. Amen. And at this time, I would like to have the children share a moment with God with our children's sermon today. In our Bible story today, we'll hear about a woman who talks with Jesus about bread and what we're supposed to do with scraps of bread. Now, you might not know what scraps are, but have you ever cut the crust off of your sandwich and thrown them away? Yeah, me too. That's what scraps are, the crusts. Now, they aren't things that we normally eat or we choose not to eat because, hey, no one really likes the crust, right? But there are some really yummy recipes we can make with scraps sometimes. Some people take scraps of bread and make yummy filling. Some people fry up scraps of bread and make croutons. Do you know what croutons are? They're the things you put on tops of salad. They're really good. And sometimes, if we buy too much food and know we won't eat it all, we'll take food to a local shelter where people who don't have food can eat and can really enjoy it so our food doesn't go bad. Today for lunch, you might be having a sandwich with some bread. How many of you are planning on having a sandwich for lunch? You can raise your hands at home or tell someone at your house that you're having a sandwich for lunch. If you are, I thought I could teach you how to make something called a blessing sandwich. Now, even if you don't have all of the ingredients I'm going to name in the sandwich I'm making, that doesn't mean you can't still use these ingredients in your daily life throughout this week. And you'll understand what I mean in a minute. For our bread, we have do something with your heart, because bread is hearty. Do something nice for someone you love. So anytime you have bread this week, think of doing something nice for someone you love. For our condiments, we have mayo, we have lettuce, we have pickles. Our lettuce, be green and recycle this week. Mayo, stick up for something you believe in. Pickles, pick up after yourself. And for our meat, take care of any animals you may have or find out ways you can help animals in our community. Whew, that seems like it's gonna be a really big sandwich, don't you think? But do you think in this next week you could get this whole sandwich finished, all of the things we said we would do? Do you think you can do something with your heart, stick up for something you believe in, be green and recycle, pick up after yourself, and take care of your animals somehow? You do? You think you can do all of that? That's great. Let's pray to God and thank our God for always being a blessing to us in all of the work we do. Dear God, we give you thanks for showing us how to love and care for others. Thank you for being our God and always loving us through all of the work we do. We pray this in your name. Amen. We'll now be moving on to the reading of our collect. Let us join in the reading of our collect. Holy Creator, lead us from inaction to action, from silence to speaking. Amen. Our gospel reading today comes to us from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 15, verses 21 to 28. Let us listen to the word of God from this ancient story, which I'll be reading today from the Good News translation. Jesus left that place and went off to the territory near the cities of Tyre and Sidon. A Canaanite woman who lived in that region came to him. "Son of David," she cried out, "have mercy on me, sir. My daughter has a demon and is in a terrible condition." But Jesus did not say a word to her. His disciples came to him and begged him, "Send her away. She is following us and making all this noise." Then Jesus replied, "I have been sent only to the lost sheep of the people of Israel." At this, the woman came and fell at his feet. "Help me, sir," she said. Jesus answered, "It isn't right to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." "That's true, sir," she said. "But even the dogs eat the leftovers that fall from their master's table." So Jesus answered her, "You are a woman of great faith. What you want will be done for you." And at that very moment, her daughter was healed. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Let us pray. Holy God, so often we are consumed by what we are consuming, whether it be the news on TV or what we are having for dinner. Let us feast on your words today. Amen. Jesus is greeted, or more aptly, talked at, by a one woman welcoming committee as he and his disciples continue their journey today in the territory near Tyre and Sidon. A woman whose name we do not know comes and pleads with Jesus, "Have mercy on me, sir. My daughter has a terrible condition." The daughter is nowhere to be seen in this story. What did this woman, this Canaanite woman, think Jesus was going to do if her daughter was not with her? What did she expect to happen? If your child is sick, you take them to the doctor. You don't go to the doctor yourself and describe their symptoms and expect your child to be healed from miles away. And perhaps that's why the disciples start to get irate with her persistence. She didn't even bring her daughter. Send her away. She just keeps nagging us to help. How can we help her when she isn't willing to help herself just a little bit? But how many of us here are parents? Pet parents count too. Raise your hands, it's okay. And how many of us here would do anything to help our children, fur children or human children, feel better if they were ill, sick, or otherwise just not okay? This woman, this Canaanite woman, whose ancestors are the same as Jesus's, Ruth, Naomi, and Rahab, has a long line of strong women before her who stood up in the face of opposition to find justice, to speak up for those who couldn't speak for themselves. The ancestors she can call upon for wisdom and guidance have provided her with a lens of gratitude of how to speak up and speak out. So when the disciples try to send her away, she persists. When Jesus talks down to her, because he does, she persists. Jesus compares what the woman is doing to a dog begging for scraps at a table, an insult heaped on her by a man she had bowed down to just moments before. But this mama bear does not back away. She counters, saying, "Even the dogs eat the leftovers that fall from the master's table." This woman, this mother, does not allow the way she is spoken to, talked down to deter her from what she came for, her daughter who is hurting, who needs healing, her daughter whose name we do not know, whose ailment is unbeknownst to us aside from being told she is possessed by a demon. But can you hear the plea in this mother's voice? "Even the dogs eat the scraps from the leftovers from the master's table." Does God's self not hear her plea? This mother is not above taking what little Jesus may have to offer, for even just a little bit can sustain a starving dog. Even just a little bit of faith of God at work can sustain us. There are so many mothers and mothering figures in our world who are pleading and pleading with the world, "Help my child, I am doing all I can, but I can't do this work alone." And all too often we see the world respond in the way that Jesus' disciples did. "Send her away, she's being annoying, she didn't even bring what she could." We see the world respond in the way Jesus did, in haste and perhaps a bit of frustration. And I have to admit, in this story, I don't want to be like Jesus. He's very human in this moment, this very rare glimpse of his not so loving side. I want to be like the mother, willing to do what it takes to care for the ones I love, even if it means fighting with all I have for getting the resources that are needed. Living in a first world country, it's unfathomable to me that we don't have health care, which is accessible to all. That people have to wonder if they can afford to go to the doctor to have preventative treatments because their copay is so high, or because they do not have health insurance at all, or because they are not employed full-time, or their employer does not have to provide them with health care. God, do you hear our plea that all may be cared for? Living in a first world country, I still cannot wrap my head around the notion that we do not have enough food to feed the people who hunger on our streets, the children who hunger when they do not have a fresh meal at school. God, do you hear our plea that all may be fed? Living in a first world country where people are living on the streets because they cannot afford their homes, because they have been evicted due to addiction, because they could not afford the health care to receive treatments to help them, because they have lost their jobs due to downsizing, which once provided them with health care. God, do you hear our plea that all may feel safe, that all may feel loved and heard and seen? Our story today demonstrated that God is always with us, right there as we are begging and pleading for things to get better. But it also demonstrated the very humid side of this work, that at times, regardless of how much we may say we want things to change, we have to be part of that action plan, for God is with us in that work. Let us pray. God of wisdom and grace, you have given us eyes to see what is happening, ears to hear what is going on. Let us use our God-given abilities so we may be agents of change, so all may see, hear, and experience your love in this world. Amen. Thank you. I invite you now to prepare your hearts and minds for prayer. If you feel called in body or spirit, you may place your hands in a prayerful pose, reminded no matter where we pray from, no matter what stance we may be taking, God hears us calling. Let us pray. Holy, holy, holy God, parent of us all, we pray today for the children, for those who hunger in this world. We ask that you open not only our eyes, but move our heart and feet to action, so all may be fed. We pray in this moment for all of those who are caring for and raising children. We ask that you give them guidance in moments when they feel lost. Bring patience when it is easier to anger, to have moments of joy in the midst of hardship. Parent of us all, care for the parents and parenting figures of this world. We hold in the stillness of this moment the earth and all of its creatures. Help us be stewards of this planet which you so lovingly created, O God. Help us use our hands to plant fruit which yields goodness and mercy, and to pluck up that which does not bring life. We pray for our educators and students as they prepare to return to school, whatever that may look like for them. We ask that you bring calm in the moments of anxiety. We ask that you guide the leaders in local and state governments as decisions are made for the well-being of those who return to in-person teaching. And we pray for those who are embarking on new learning online or in other modalities, O God. God, be with the teachers, students, and all of those involved in shaping the minds of young people. And we pray for those we hold in the closeness of our hearts. We pray for our friends and family. We pray for our brothers in Christ, Ray and Roger. And we pray for our sisters, Jean, Heather, Amy, and Barb. And we ask you, O God, that you make your presence known and bring comfort to the family and friends of Jim Beaver, who passed away earlier this week. We also remember in this sacred stillness our beloved friends Doris, Mary, Betty Lou, Mary, and Grace. And we join our bodies in a prayerful pose, united in prayer as your Son, Jesus Christ, taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. A woman whose name we do not know taught Jesus something about using even the scraps on the table. While we may not have much to give, God can work through even the smallest amount that we have to offer. We give our offering today not because we have so much to offer to this world, but because God can do so much through what little we can offer. You may give your offering online today by going to the website in the description of this video. You may also send your offering into the church at our address, Quentin United Church of Christ, P.O. Box 1138, 11 East Main Street, Quentin, PA, 17083. This information is also available in the description of this video. Let us give thanks for the gifts which have been offered today, for the gifts which will be shared, and the work which God will do through all of these gifts. God, take these gifts and make a bountiful feast from them. Let what has been given here today feed, clothe, and care for your people in this world. Amen. Let us rejoice as God's people as we listen to our closing hymn, His Eye is on the Sparrow. Quentin UCC folk, our time of worship has come to an end, but that does not mean the work of the church is done, for it is just beginning. We leave this time of worship as we leave a dinner table, knowing there is much to clean up in this world, and also knowing God will be with us in this work that we do in the world. Go from this place in the peace and love of Jesus Christ, the peace and love and the ambition to change the world, as a mother's fierce love is determined to do. Let us listen to our Sunday hymn, Lord, make me more holy.